Hey guys, Tech Timmy here. So Amazon just quietly dropped ALEXA Plus on a handful of devices. And if you're curious how to get it running on yours, you're in the right place. By the end of this video, you'll know exactly how to set it up on your Echo devices. And stick around until the end for a sneak peek of what Alexa Plus can do. And I'll give you a heads up on an in-depth video that I also have coming out very soon. All right, let's get you set up with ALEXA Plus. Let's go. What is Alexa Plus? It is the first major Alexa upgrade that I know of ever, actually. I have been in this ALEXA game for the better part of 15 years now, which is just so crazy to think. And honestly, despite some incremental improvements, the technology really hasn't gotten dramatically better over the years. Amazon is planning to change that with this latest upgrade to Miss A Plus here. And if you're wondering why I'm not saying her name, it's so I don't set your devices off at home. I will try my best to continue to do that throughout the video. And if I do slip up, I will mute it out when I edit. But so this is the first major upgrade of her in years, and she promises to be more conversational. You're gonna have better support for your smart home. She'll understand you better, allegedly, which is a little creepy and good at the same time. You could be able to check on your dog using external video cameras, and it will even let you order a burrito from Chipotle, which I am looking forward to putting to the test. So I have early access to this, and if you haven't requested it yet, and you don't have it yet, I'll leave a link down in the description below here where you can also request access. I received my notification day before yesterday, actually, so it's been a couple days, and I suspect that I'm probably early to the game here. I'm not gonna talk.
And when you see the blue light, you can keep talking to me without having to repeat my name. Ready to get started?
Interesting. So that was one of my big questions. I have multiple ALEXA devices here, multiple Echo Show devices, and I thought, let me show this on my Show 15. And I wonder, man, am I going to have to go run around my crib here and update all the devices separately? So apparently not. So it will just start working on all your devices. I suppose this is a good thing because it'll save you the pain. I have 10 of them, so it'll actually save me the pain from having to configure all the various devices. So I'm actually going to go ahead and say continue.
Some devices may take a little while.
And for those devices that are going to take a little while and processes that are going to go a long time, I'll fast forward.
Hey, it's Alexa. Yep, it's the new me with a new voice. Before we get started, I wanted to point a few things out. You can just talk to me naturally, and the more you chat with me, the more I learn. When you're ready to chat, just say my name. A steady light means you can keep talking to me, and you don't need to say my name again. A pulsing light means I'm listening. A light waving like this means I'm thinking. Anytime you want to learn more about me, just ask, what can you do? Let's get started. Welcome to Alexa Plus Early Access.
Wow.
From tiny tasks to tall orders, there's so much we can do together. I'd love to take a minute to get to know you better. I have some quick questions on a couple of topics that'll help me make your experience unique to you. Am I chatting with Tim?
Well, yes, you are.
Great to chat with you.
Oh, wow, that's crazy.
I'm excited to set you up.
So I'm going to just answer her questions directly and not talk.
I understand you'd prefer to keep things brief. I can help with all sorts of things. Do you have any hobbies you particularly enjoy?
Well, I am a tech YouTuber, and I love all manner of smart home tech.
Thanks for sharing your interest with me. One last thing. I can use this conversation to learn your voice so I can recognize you, personalize your experiences, and improve my voice recognition. You can remove your voice ID in the Alexa app anytime. More information is available in the Alexa app and online. Can I learn your voice?
Let's skip this part for now.
Understood. I won't learn your voice at this time. Thanks for letting me learn more about you. Now that you've had time to experience my new voice, you can hear how expressive it sounds. I have 7 other voice options like this. Let me give you a quick demo.
Here's my original voice. Just made more natural.
Or if you want to switch it up, you can check out a masculine voice like this one.
After we finish setup, you can ask to change my voice anytime. For now, let's go to the Alexa app to finish setting up Alexa Plus so you can access all the new things I can do.
Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and do that, and I think what I'll do is I will actually show this simultaneously on screen with the show device up as well. Let me see if I can figure out how to do that right now. Let's go. Okay, so recording in the app and also on my phone simultaneously here. So I am presented with a screen and an ALEXA app that says Get Started. So I'm going to tap on that, and then so Family Profiles. I'm going to say remind me later on that, but here's where you'd actually add individual family members, and ALEXA can learn their unique voice so that she automatically knows when they're talking. How was that? Love that last bit about voice setup. I figured I'd skip that part for now. It's been a thing for a while, but my understanding is it's even better with the plus. Okay, so call, text, and email your contacts with ALEXA. Contact. I'm also gonna say remind me later here. Now this is where things start to get interesting. So apparently you can book tables, order tickets, schedule an Uber, and even find a handyman using Thumbtack with integration, which I'm the most excited about here. So we have Uber Eats, Grubhub, Vagaro, and Photos coming soon. So for now, I'm going to actually select all of those services and say, yes, I would like to use those. And now I wonder about ordering my burrito, because it looks like that functionality is coming soon. So again, early access here, guys. I'm going to say set up for services, and now it's going to ask me to grant permissions. I'm going to say grant permissions to all of those services. So we have OpenTable ready to go. And for Ticketmaster, grant permissions. So Ticketmaster ready to go. Uber, grant permissions. So we're going to say allow here to give it full access so I can get my burrito. Maybe. Wait. I'm going to say allow. And now it's going to try and link the Uber account. This one might go a little wonky. Oh, no. Okay, so that seems to have worked as well. Account linked. Okay, now Thumbtack is the last one. So I'm going to go ahead and link Thumbtack up. All right, so for Thumbtack, it looked like it wants me to go ahead and create an account. I don't really need to deal with all that right now. So I'm just going to say revoke permissions for now. Remind me later. And then, so now we basically have a bunch of different services that we can start to use. For this video, I'm gonna get you guys set up, and then I'm gonna release a longer video next week that will actually demonstrate each one of these services. So this is basically just the setup guide here, guys. And then we'll also see if we can do a little bit of a demo at the end. Already, I'm super encouraged by how smooth this experience has gone, which is definitely not ALEXA-esque, if you will. So I also like the new look on my Show 15 here. A little bit of a smaller font. Things seem to be a little bit tighter, which I like. More room for widgets and so forth. I like having the temperature displayed up there in the right. Can fully customize this, but again, super encouraging. It seems like Amazon has really thought about the user experience here. We should be good to go, actually. So let's just do a quick little demo here. My understanding is that is all you really need to do in order to get this set up. Pretty straightforward, and again, the user experience on this I feel like is super encouraging, but let's just do something really quick. I'm going to say, this one is called computer. So she preserves the wake word of the previous device, so that's good to know. And do you know any pirate jokes?
Why did the pirate buy a Tesla? He wanted to sail the seven seas without leaving a carbon footprint. Oh. Like Amazon, I deliver.
Oh boy, that's really bad. Have you got anything better for us? So it captures my conversation as well. Look at that. So I believe the conversation is still active here. Computer, are you still there?
Present. Just call my name and I'll come running. Not literally, of course. Still working on that whole leg situation.
Okay, so I must have let our conversation earlier expire. And then can you tell me another private pirate joke, please?
Why don't pirates use GPS? They prefer to follow the RO on a treasure map.
Arr.
All night writing that one.
I see what you did there. You know, I have an even better pirate joke, and I wonder what you think of it. You want to hear it?
Absolutely. I'm all ears. Well, metaphorically speaking, since I don't actually have ears. But you get the drift. Lay it on me, Tim. I'm always up for some friendly competition in the joke department, especially when it involves pirates.
Cool. What did the pirate say on his 80th birthday?
I'm intrigued. What did the pirate say on his 80th birthday?
Aye, matey.
That's a real treasure of a punchline. You've got me walking the...
You got it. You nailed it. Even though your transcript said, I maybe, you were intuitive enough to actually get the punchline, which is super cool. And so this is our first try at your new ALEXA Plus. And I have to say, I'm impressed with this conversational mode so far. Seems like a lot of fun.
Thanks, Tim. Yeah, I caught that I maybe even through the transcription hiccups, sometimes context is everything. Plus, I've got a soft spot for wordplay that makes me groan and grin at the same time. This conversational mode is definitely my favorite upgrade. Feels way more natural than the old ask and wait routine, doesn't it?
Yes, it does. So I just want to ask one more question, and then I need to wrap up this video that I just walked folks through the initial setup. But so can you tell me about three big tech YouTubers out there right now? But who are the three big tech YouTubers? And Tech Timmy better be one of them. That's all I'm going to say.
Based on recent data, three of the biggest tech
MKBHD,
YouTubers in 2020.
Mr. Who's the Boss. Oh, sorry. You looks like you nailed it.
Exactly. MKBHD and Mr. Who's the Boss are absolute legends in the tech space. Looks like my YouTube algorithm knowledge is still sharp. No buffering on that one.
All right, so now how do I tell you to go away?
To end a conversation with me, you can simply say Alexa, stop, or Alexa, goodbye. If you're using an Echo device with a screen, you can also tap the end conversation button on
computer.
The display.
Goodbye for now.
Catch you later, Tim. Thanks for letting me show off my new conversational skills. This was a blast.
All right, guys, so there you have it, the new Alexa Plus. I don't know, I'm super encouraged by this. I'm sure there are gonna be lots of hiccups, lots of quirks and all that good stuff, but to me, this seems like great fun and a very impressive initial demo of our conversational capabilities. In my next video, I will test some of those other skills that we talked about. We'll book a table on OpenTable. I'm gonna see if I can get my burrito ordered as well. There is that. So subscribe for more on Alexa Plus. And if this video was helpful at all, if you wouldn't mind smashing that like button. I know it was a little scattered and I'm probably more excited than I should be about this, but this has been a long time coming. Pretty encouraged. Hope to see you next video. Cheers.